Julie.
Thank you, Renate. I'm afraid I'm going to be a bit boring after Nada's presentation. That has been documented by, of course, several Bahraini organizations, but also by international organizations such as FIDH, Amnesty International, the Cairo Institute for Human Rights Studies. I will focus on Nabil Rajab's case in particular because FIDH and OMCT just released a report that you can find on the table. It's available in English and Arabic about judicial observation mission conducted on Nabil Rajab's trial. As you know, Nabil Rajab is a very well-known, prominent human rights defender, well-known at national but also at international level. He used to come in Geneva to do advocacy and interact with the UN mechanism, with diplomats, including during the UPR of Bahrain. Thanks to his international reputation, actually, Nabil has remained until May 2012 one of the few pro-democracy activists not to have been detained. Sorry. On this regard, his arrest and detention constitute a very worrying message sent by the Bahraini authorities to the international community, but also to the Human Rights Council in particular, as Nabil's case, it's also a clear case of reprisals against human rights defenders that have cooperated with the Council. On this regard, I would like also to mention the very recent report released by the Cairo Institute for Human Rights Studies, that have highlighted several cases of reprisals against Bahraini human rights defenders, like Mohamed El Maskati and Said Youssef case, that are also very clear cases of reprisals of human rights defenders that have been cooperated with the UN mechanism. To go back very briefly on Nabil's particular case, between September and December 2011, FIDH and OMCT carried out four missions to Manama to monitor the hearings of Mr. Rajab's trial. And our report clearly demonstrates that the trial in appeal against Mr. Rajab failed to comply with international standards of fair trial. For us, from our perspective and from where we have been documented, the Ontario procedure was fraught with serious human rights violations from the time of arrest through detention, trial, and conviction. So as of today, Nabil has been in detention for 247 days. Mm-hmm. And we see his detention and his sentence as arbitrary. So we submit the cases to the UN Working Group on arbitrary detention that should release an opinion on Nabil in August. And for us, there is no doubt that the Working Group will qualify his detention of arbitrary according to the very detailed information that we submit to the Working Group. Mr. Rajab's trial clearly reflects Bahraini's policy in a more global and more general trend of criminalizing and silencing human rights defenders and other dissenting voices in a context where, as Nada said, these voices are particularly needed to find peaceful solutions to resolve the current crisis. The Bahraini authorities have committed on several occasions, including here in Geneva, in front of you, to implement the recommendations issued by the BC, including the release of all prisoners of opinion. But as you know, Nabil Rajab is still detained. So as Nada said, he's held in a prison together with ordinary criminals. Yeah. So most of other prisoners of conscience are held together in a separate unit. So it's a big concern for us. FIDH and other international organizations here in Geneva have advocated, together with our Bahraini partners, to obtain firm condemnation from Western countries, and in particular from the EU, regarding the repression of human rights defenders. Of course, we welcome the fact that the EU has regularly called on the Bahraini authorities to implement the recommendation of BC and express concerns around the sentencing of activists, and has also given its support to the statement made by Switzerland during the session. However, EU public statements have failed till today to make explicit calls for the immediate and unconditional release of those activists. So we urge the EU in Geneva actually to work together with Switzerland to have a more active role at the Human Rights Council and to support establishment of an international monitoring mechanism that is really needed, with the mandate of monitoring the implementation of the BC and of the UPR of Bahrain, including those related to human rights defenders. So we definitely hope that human rights defenders could be at this finally at the Human Rights Council, and that a resolution will be adopted at the next session. Okay.